Hello everyone, here is Andrea Amighetti and today I'm gonna show you how to create a full skin fade with, in this case, a curly forward look on top, only with the use of your scissors. We're gonna start by dividing the top panel from the sides and the back into a natural division by following the natural shape of the hair and by creating with our fingers against the scalp of our model a line that will represent number 3 guard with our scissors. Once we terminated that, we're gonna start joining the line that we created with our first section with some scissors over comb. So we're gonna basically debulk to make as light as possible the sides. So once we're gonna connect the top, we're gonna be able to connect it on a debulked side and we're not gonna get confused with the length of the perimeter. We're now gonna work the top with concave layers that connects on the perimeter of our initial guideline. We're gonna maintain the direction on the sides of each half of the top panel, and we're gonna connect most of the top with the sides with a little disconnection towards the front. We're gonna now touch up the front just to make sure there's no hair sticking out of the shape we choose in the beginning. We're gonna now isolate the crown area of our top panel and we're gonna find the referral point from the back panel to start to build up the shape desired on the top. Remember that we're working the top on concave layers, so there's not gonna need the use of vertical sectioning on the top. We're just simply gonna join all the length in the middle to create a shorter middle part and a longer edge. We're gonna now continue collecting most of the apex area into the guideline that we are creating in our concave layers, and by pushing everything again in the middle, we're gonna continue carving the concavity towards the top panel. So we can finally define our top panel shape, which is triangular, so progressive, that gets longer towards the front, vertically and horizontally concave, so shorter in the middle and longer on the corners. We're gonna now proceed by blow drying first the sides towards the front and apply some Sleek Gorilla sea salt on the top of our hair to give a little bit more of texture and style throughout the whole haircut. And once we blow dry everything, we can finally start with our scissor fade. This is a process that's gonna take quite a while, obviously differently from a clipper. Each stroke of our scissor is gonna be manually done, and especially when we talk about buzzing the fade from zero, like are we seeing now, it's gonna take a particular precision and care. We're gonna start by first creating a line with our scissors by keeping the scissors as close as possible to the skin. And once we finished our line, we're gonna start working with the tip of our scissor, which needs to be sharp. And we're gonna start removing each little chunk of hair. Many people have been asking, how can I do this without risking to cut the skin? And the concept is very simple, and I am sure this is gonna kind of make sense once I'm gonna explain it. The real trick here is to make sure that every little strokes we do is gonna terminate by pulling slightly the scissors towards the back. So when we're cutting, we're not pushing, pulling out our scissors. And as you can see here, I'm giving a shape up to our model with my scissors going as close as possible. And now we're gonna finish by shaving what's left. And you can see from my hand how the strokes are going up and down lightly, and that's needed not to cut the skin, to make sure that the scissor is just gonna grab what's outside the skin and is not gonna fold the skin into our blades. So once we've done that, again, we're gonna continue creating our line all around the head, first with the tip of our scissor, and then we're gonna start shaving all the bottom. Here, guys, the concept is pretty simple. We're gonna go with a descendant technique. So we're gonna start from the longest hair on the top, which we established in the beginning, and we're gonna go lower and lower, using first the largest teeth of our comb, and by moving to the thinnest on the closest shape. We're gonna, after, once we finish our scissors over comb technique, gonna go with the point of our scissors to cancel the zero that we created, the zero line, the light line. It is quite clear that we're using two main techniques, scissors over comb and point cutting, and that's pretty much the only two techniques we're gonna keep using the whole haircut. It's quite clear that obviously with scissors over comb we cannot possibly reach the closest shave, because obviously the comb is in between our skin and our scissors, so we always will leave a little millimeter or so of length if we want to keep safe and cut with our scissors over comb. So my best advice is to go as close as possible with our scissors over comb, which is the safest way of cutting the sides. And once we cannot reach anymore, we're gonna go and proceed with our point cutting by maintaining the point and the scissors vertical and not flat to the surface of the skin to avoid any cut. Once defined the transition, we're gonna go with point cutting to clear up all the dark patches with a freestyle technique. So let's recap again, because obviously this is the only technique we're gonna use all around the hair. Scissors over comb, first with the wide teeth, then with the thin teeth, and point cutting to remove the zero line, and in the end some freestyle point cutting throughout the fade to clean it as much as possible. And guys, that's pretty much it. There's no much else to say. The other two things that you need is a lot of patience and passion to continue and finish our haircut, and not to give up your scissors and pick up your clipper, because obviously a clipper will do this job much faster, but I disagree that it will do it better. Of course, if we can cut time, we can spend our time more wisely to finish our fade. And I wouldn't recommend this into a salon, but refining a skill like this will help you to refine your fades with scissors over comb, which is what I think the best tool to refine your fade, simply for the reason that you can control each single stroke differently from the clipper, and is relying on the strength of your hand. So depending on how strongly we're gonna close our scissor, we're gonna have a different effect. It's a skill that everybody should learn and everybody should practice on before moving into barbering and fading. Not because, again, I think it's necessary in the barbershop, but it's like going to the gym and training your hands to work in a certain position. And I think it's vital to know and to have a maximum control with our scissors in the barbershop, on not only on long trims, but even on fades. Now I'm gonna let you enjoy the rest of the process till the end of our video. We're gonna now proceed with our razor to clean up and refine all the edges by sharpening up our shape up previously done with our scissors, and to shave around the ears and on the neck the hair that we left with our scissor blend. I'm gonna touch up with the razor as well some patches that they're gonna stay once I'll shave the neck of my client to make sure that the transition isn't ruined by the passage of the razor.